thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments. Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
We're calling the meeting to order. Mr. Turner, you have the honors.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You bow your heads with me, please. Father God, we thank you for this beautiful fall day and for the beautiful weather over the past week that allows the citizens of this county and the state to come out and express their will on who's going to lead them over the next 2 and 4 years. We thank you that we live in a country where citizens have the right to do that, and we hope we never forget the soberness of that fact. Lord, we thank you, and we ask that we continue to be mindful and that you continue to bless the people of Western North Carolina who continue to suffer from the storm that ravaged that place. And we thank the helping hands of those who continue to go out and offer support. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Will you join us for the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have the approval of the agenda. Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve.
And we have a second from Mr. Lashley. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
We only have one public speaker. And sir, you're on the back row. Come forward.
Thank you.
Who is it?
Jose Molina.
He'll see, yeah. If you state your name and address.
Appreciate it. Good evening, County Commissioners. My name is Jose Molina. I'm at 413 Helly Long Lane in the city of Burlington. I was here on July the 15th, and I asked who is the one who inspect our school buildings for needs and repairs and maintenance and hazards all around the ground, school grounds and the buildings. And you said that the health department does once a year an inspection. And they do. So I went on and I asked the questions. I did my homework. And I wanted to read you some of the reports that says for three schools, the three schools that I know. I wish I knew all 38. So it says water stains on ceiling tiles on all three schools. Two of the schools had water pressure on the water fan that needs to be repaired. Also, one of the schools, the blue stripe paint is peeling off on a section, which in my what I have seen is all over the hallways. Mm-hmm. So it's not just in a section. That's what the health department said. According to these three reports, those three schools are great. We have no issues with them. Well, unfortunately, this report doesn't tell you the whole stage of the building or the whole story of how the buildings are. And I did send you an email with pictures. I wanted to print them out, but in the printer, they don't look as clear as on the things. So the health department, number one, they have rules and guidelines that they have to follow. So those things allow to them to go too deep into it. Also, they cannot force the district to make the repairs, which if the district doesn't want to do it, they're not going to do it. And the third one is that, unfortunately, the health department, that's what they are. They are health experts. So they are not building experts, and they're probably not looking for certain hazards that other experts will be able to find. And I send you those pictures. On the first picture, it's a clogged gutter that it's Andrews Elementary School, which have been there for months. The way on the, you will see it on the picture that it had been there for months, and that gutter, when I checked it the last time, we didn't have any rain for like almost 6 to 8 weeks, and there was water still inside of that gutter. So that means the roof is having standing water, which is never a good thing, and the repair for that could be a few hundred dollars, but if we let it be like that, it's going to cost us probably millions of dollars, which obviously we don't want. And the second picture is there is a set of broken steps that leads from the school building to the bus lot. Okay. A set of steps that every morning gets used for, you know, hundreds of students that come in and out of that building. And it was reported once, twice, three times. And by the look on the pictures, if you can get a little closer into it, you will see that the metal inside the steps is rusting out, meaning that it have been like that for quite a bit. The hand railings paint, it's peeling off. You cannot use that hand railing because you're gonna get the paint inside of your hand, so it's not safe for the kids. And the third picture, it's obviously some dead trees that, you know, they have been there for a while. They did remove some of them, but 60% they did work on it, but 40% they left it on there. So I'm asking the local government, and if this message goes to the state government, to do a little bit more with our public schools. It's unfair for the taxpayers that they keep paying, and our children's, almost 23,000 of them, are suffering. So that's what.
Would you state which three schools you're referring to?
The schools that I took an example of, and that I read those reports, are Andrews Elementary Schools, Cummins High School, and Broadview Middle School. And I wish I knew all of them, but.
Okay, your time is up, but. Board, we never allow comment at this point, but this is the only speaker. Would you entertain a motion to allow us to address this issue?
So moved.
Second.
And I don't want to do this unless everybody agrees. Everybody that agrees, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any nays? All right, we're going to address this issue. This will never happen again.
Right. I appreciate that.
But we're going to on this occasion. The health board simply is required to do an inspection. As you pointed out, they cannot mandate the corrections. That's up to the school board, and we county commissioners have no way of enforcing or making the school board do anything. So I would plead with you, I don't know when their next meeting is, but go to the school board and have this same conversation.
It'll be in November.
Mr. Turner, comments?
I'll just echo yours. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I agree. I didn't get it. I don't have your email. And I checked with Chair Paisley, and he said he hadn't gotten it either. So where did you send it? Do you know?
Just before I got here.
Oh,
just
tonight? Okay. Yeah, I hadn't looked at it in the last hour or so.
Ms. Thompson.
Yeah, I'll tell you about the paint, Cummins. Every 6 years we were painting schools, so many schools every year to try to get a 6-year cycle where every school would have been painted. Lots of money. Cummins was in the hundreds of thousands. And when they painted Cummins, they used the wrong kind of paint. And when the kids would lean up against the strip with a book bag, it would peel. Mm. And then the kids would, you know, that's what we do. It's like when you get burnt, you peel. It don't matter. It was the wrong kind of paint. The company that painted the school set up in the parking lot and was 3 months late into the school year after not finishing it in the summer. So when the teachers and everybody went home, they got all their stuff in the middle of their classroom to paint the whole system. The whole school there at Cummins, and when they come back, it wasn't finished. So wrong paint, big failure, and then just bumping up guns, because I was over there not too long ago when we did the walkthrough when Dr. Fleming was sworn in, and I saw it. And as a board member, I referred to this paint company as they need to get their little blue paintbrush back down here in Alamance County and finish that. They never did, and a couple of the assistant principals had to finish the lines to where they were peeled. Well, you could see exactly like where it peeled and it wasn't sanded. So when you painted over it, you could, it, you know what I'm talking about. And so it was not done right. And it looks like not done right. It still does. Because when I was over there, it's the same way. And it's the same way with our baseball field. It's the same way with Cummins. It's, you know, we'll get to you when we see fit. Those steps coming down that brand new auditorium is a joke, because that should all be pressure washed, because you can see how dark it is on the cement. It's back to that Band-Aid stuff again. You get half of it done and the other half. So, and that's on all of us, not just them, but all of us when it comes to funding. So, and priorities. And Graham and Cummins have got to be priorities, because a lot of times they're not. But the kids are the priority, and that's what matters, just like having that baseball field ready when they've got kids wanting to have a baseball team. But the thing behind all that is going to be parent support, because you've got to have a strong PTO, you've got to have a strong booster club, you've got to have parents that want to be there and step up for their kids, because that's what you'll see a successful school is. You can tell the parents are highly involved because of what they do for the school system as well. So it takes a whole family, so to speak, to do that. But the paint job in Cummins is a cluster, and I'll say that nicely, because it was the, they didn't use the kind of paint. They used latex where they should use the other, and if you touched it, it would peel right off. So that was a biggie from the beginning, but it was still paid for.
Mr. Lashley.
Thank you, Chairman. And Mr. Molina, thank you for coming tonight and bringing this to our attention. Unfortunately, we know about this stuff. The school system, we gave the school system over $55 million this year to take care of problems this thing. You, as an Alamance County taxpayer, are responsible for maintaining and operating the school system. That's the only thing you're responsible for. I would suggest and just reiterate what the chairman had told you about going to the school board and having the same conversation with them. Ask them why these schools are this way, because it's not like we haven't given them the money to take care of it. I guess that's all I can really say about it. And I just want to thank you for being a conscientious citizen and going and looking at these things and just bring it to our attention. Thank you for the photographs.
Mr. Carter.
Well, I already commented, so.
And so have I. Please go to the school board. Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Next is our consent agenda. Do we have a motion as to the consent agenda?
Motion to approve.
Second.
And a second. Before we take the vote, Mr. Stevens, you and I have had several conversations, and Ms. York, and so forth. Item number 5C are rights of ways, deeds of easement, and so forth to the Department of Transportation. We had it on our agenda 2 weeks ago, and we moved it to this week because the deeds were drawn so poorly that we could not execute them. Have some of those improvements been, or revisions been made by DOT?
That's correct, Mr. Paisley. I've spoken with the DOT's contractor related to the issues that we discussed. They've made some of the requested changes on our behalf, and we reviewed the newest and the most up-to-date versions of each of the agreements, and they're on the agenda tonight.
And with three rights-of-way, ingress and egress, they don't even do not have a legal description of the property that we're granting an easement to. Is that correct?
That's correct. So the DOT has its own way of drafting these documents that is somewhat different than what normally transpires in a land taking. They also have their own statutory framework for the process by which they have to undertake these takings. And so they've indicated to me in conversation this week that if the county chooses not to accept their formatting, they're not going to make changes on our behalf, and they'll proceed with filing suit and taking the land.
All right. If they do that, then I know the procedure. They could take the land statutorily, and then we would have hearings as to the valuation of the taking.
That's correct, yes.
Do you think that's in our best interest that we do that?
Well, we could rebut the assertion that the land is for public use and public interest, potentially, but I don't think we could make that argument successfully based on the land that's actually being acquired. So yes, like you said, the only real argument we would have is for the value. And I will say that based on the value we are being paid, I think we're being paid fairly. So any argument to the contrary would be difficult for us to make.
All right. I've only practiced law for 51 years, and I've never seen, I don't know that I've seen a group of documents that were that poorly drawn. I think you called the state bar and found that the drafters of the documents were not attorneys. Is that correct?
That's correct. So the drafters are not attorneys. The DOT purports to have authority for their employees who are non-attorney staff to draft the deeds and the easements. And then they have attorneys with the AG's office who review documents. I can't and I won't comment on whether or not I think their review was sufficient, but this is what we're left with and this is our option.
All right. And you and I think, talked about nobody is objecting to the taking, that is the widening of the Graham Hopedale Road and so forth.
Right.
Nobody's arguing about the monies they're offering. It's just that the deeds are so insufficient that if I were an attorney representing a purchaser, I would tell them no way. But it's still in our best interest, according to you, and I think as well, to go ahead and execute these deeds. Is that correct?
I think that's correct. In conversation with the contractor, I think we agree that the land they're purporting to take is in comport with the map they've supplied us, and we've mapped out the meets and bounds in our software as well. I think we all understand what's being taken. And keep in mind, these are easements, so this is not necessarily a fee simple transfer in every sense. But I think we're in good shape to sign these.
That's all I needed. Board, I'm going to vote that we leave this on the consent agenda and approve it, but I felt like the board needed this information before we took the action.
I'll second your motion.
Real quick, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Stevens, was the DOT at least cordial in their emphatic threat to sue us?
they were cordial, and they said we would hate to have to go to that length to get this done, but they did indicate that they want to start construction early in 2025, and they're going to do that one way or the other.
Okay. I like that statement.
Very nice.
One way or the other, right? That's kind of clear.
Okay. We have a motion and a second as to the consent agenda. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Unanimous. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you for the clarification and research that you and your team did.
Of course.
Okay. There are no new matters on the agenda. I love this meeting.
So
County Attorney's Report.
Nothing else for me other than learning a lot about the DOT's condemnation process.
County Manager.
Good evening, Commissioners. I have the June 2024 investment report under the County Manager's reports, but it's actually a finance report, and Susan would be happy to answer any questions she might have about what's in the investment report. Other than that, I have no further information.
Board, any questions? We all reviewed it.
Bad question. I have three questions, but we can go over this later because it's not astronomically important. I just wanted to let you know that I noticed that your percentages are much north of the 0.5% we were getting just a few months ago. Mm-hmm. Everything's north of 5%, which is mm-hmm. good for your part. I did have a question about the totals.
Okay.
Let me just make sure I'm asking you the proper question. I see that at the very bottom on page 2, mm-hmm. there's a total of $6,225,000. Is that the total amount that's being invested? I saw a number that was $138 million.
So the $6.2 million, that is the interest that was earned in that 6 months' time.
Right. Excellent work. Excellent. I'm sure that we will find some way to spend it. But the cash and investments reporting as of date was $181 million.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that was my that's where I wanted to focus my question on.
Right.
Our budget that we passed in July was like 224.
Mm-hmm.
So are we only using? Is that what we're using to do these things? So I know you said you're doing like 6 months out.
Right. So what you're seeing there when you're seeing cash and investments as $181 million, that is all funds with all fund balances there.
All terms.
All terms. Okay. And so what we're looking at there is how much is in the general fund, how much is in our emergency telephone service fund, the ARP dollars, all of those okay. different special funds that we have. What do we have all cash collectively? So what you'll see in here is we had $21.5 million that were in banks, the rest of that being invested, whether that be in commercial papers or at the capital management trust where we earn interest, but we still maintain that liquidity in that it's a 24-hour turnaround time that we could have cash in hand. So that's what you're seeing there okay. is just the balance of all those cash that we have invested.
And what's the longest term you have out laying out there now?
Normally, I don't go past 9 months when we're looking at commercial paper. Now, where we're looking at treasuries, those go no more than 3 years because of our investment policy. Is I can invest no more than 3 years past the purchase date.
Gotcha.
So normally there, I'm sticking to a, maybe about 2.5 years.
Okay, that's it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any questions? Ms. York, we have had a death in the family, so to speak. Do you want to announce that and so we can have a prayer, or at least ask for prayers for Mr. Walker's family?
Sure. Mr. Walker's mother has passed away. His parents are in Texas, and so he's not with us tonight, and I'm sure would appreciate your prayers.
So we as a board ask that each and every one of you pray for his family. Anything else?
Nothing for me, thank you.
Ms. Thompson, County Commissioner.
Yes, I had gotten a call from a gentleman, and you probably all got the same email, Mr. Clark, about his kudzu problem. Well, that stuff, like a terrorist. I spoke with this and then asked to see the DOT. And so I talked to Senator Gailey, and she contacted someone and said that they would be down there in the spring to spray for that. There's no fence, so goats won't work. So it's a nightmare. I went out there and took pictures, and it looks like something in a horror movie. And then Southeast, I was out. I got a bunch of calls from folks from Southeast about several car accidents out there. I know they got the traffic light, thanks to Senator Gailey, but there was a head-on collision with a parent and a student. Everybody's fine, but I was sent the picture. So I spoke with all three of our representatives about that, and I seen Dennis Rydell at a breakfast Saturday, and he's talked. Is it Reich? Reich? Whoever our guy is.
Right,
yeah. And they're going to look at possibly doing something with like a study or something. But if you put another light right there behind the school, you're just going to stop traffic. So it's like building Holly Hill Mall in the middle of Saxby Hall, and traffic's crazy. So it's just going to take a lot of something to really make sure that nobody is really hurt, because I told Dennis, I said, we don't want a fatality to have to do something serious about it. And the last thing is, I was at Hallfields this weekend I got to judge a Halloween contest for little bitty people, and we couldn't give everybody something, we had to choose. So I just ruined that. So it was five of us that got to judge, and while we're judging the cutest human beings in the world, they're at least 4 and 5 and 6 years old, all of a sudden an ambulance pulled up and a fire truck pulled up, and it was loud, and it was up there at the parking lot at the Hallfields Church. And then, it was a wreck, allegedly, near the interstate, and then the life flight helicopter. It was like being in a movie. Come across that, circled twice, and landed on the ball field, because they were going to life flight this person into the hospital. And the firemen come over and said, turn the children around to face the other way, because when they got the person out of the EMS and got them on the helicopter, the blade stopped. So that told us that this person did not, and sadly did not make it. So when they took the person back, it was just, it was something to be, Meredith Edwards and I were just sitting there, we just couldn't believe what we were watching. But I just wanted to give a massive shout out to our EMS and our fire and our everything like that, the Life helicopter, because it was just the most amazing teamwork thing I've ever seen in my life to really try to save someone's life. So we got the best, I have to say that. I know hope every county feels that way about ours, but I can say that with all confidence, and just I'm just so sorry for whoever did not make it, and you just never know. You just need to live your life to the fullest, because you just never know. But it was something to see, it really was. Something to be so proud of for Alamance County. They really know what they're doing.
Mr. Lashley.
I have nothing, Chairman. Thank you.
Mr. Turner.
Nothing tonight. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Carter.
Well, I would like to make a comment in conjunction with what Commissioner Thompson was just talking about. We have an amazing program at ACC, Community College. And we just had the entire class, it's in the paper, so it's not brand new, but the entire class of nurses all passed their state exams. Mm-hmm. We have, and the school is ranked in the top 10% in the state and the top 10% in the country in two-year colleges. ACC is an amazing campus, and so many new things going on. We've got to get the Public Safety Training Center finished, and we're running into a snag because we hadn't been able to get a bid on connecting the water and sewer, which is critical if you're going to have fire training and have a facility. So we've got to work with the college and come up with a way to make that happen. It's reaching a critical point. It's going to slow the whole project down. We had nobody bid on the project. It's a small project to connect water and sewer to the campus from green level. And we've got to make that happen somehow. So college is working on it right now to try and get the general contractor to add it in as an adjustment to their contract, and we hope that'll happen, but we'll have to see.
Just in follow-up with Halloween, Ms. Thompson, Radium Waste had an event Saturday, and it was a pumpkin. They had everything. They sold for charity, and a charity event, pumpkins. They brought in barbecue, they brought in hay rides, they had, you name it, they had it. And so a lot of kids, including my two grandchildren, had a big time. It's at the old Coble site. So we just want to thank Meridian for a job well done. I agree with your prayer earlier with the Western North Carolina. Such devastation. And I have family that has property in that area and so forth, and I've seen pictures that are worse than you've seen on the news. So all our prayers need to be with those folks. And last thing, Southern politicking has gotten just funny. There are beer boards out that I think are great. Have a great picture of myself and Ed, but sponsored by the Democratic Party. I thought they were great. And people that are passing are at speed and don't read all the words. So I'm getting a lot of positive comments out of the Democratic Party that was trying to be funny, I guess. And I appreciate that. Last thing, grandson was out campaigning this afternoon for me, and an adult in age, literally, and not in mental competency, said something of foul language to my grandson about me, and there's just absolutely no reason for that. I don't care what he votes or thinks about me or whether he votes for me or not, but you don't use profanity toward a 12-year-old child because you don't like a candidate. So I, again, hope and pray that individual pray for him, and any others that are just doing things that they should not be doing. Other than that, everybody have a, oh, and I have not had supper yet. So in the same poor attempt to be funny, I plan to go to McDonald's to go through the drive-thru and get fresh fries. But anyway, do we have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
A motion and second. All in favor, signify by saying aye. Guys, see you in 2 weeks.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Commissioner meetings typically occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers at the County Office Building at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. The first Monday meeting begins at 9:30 a.m. and the third Monday meeting begins at 6:30 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the county website at www.alamance-nc.com. The video of this meeting will be broadcast on LocalGov TV. Please go to www.localgovtvnc.com for more information about their schedule and to see more videos produced by your local governments. You can also access this meeting through our YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/AlamanceCountyNC or by clicking the YouTube link on the county website. Technical questions regarding this meeting's broadcast or production may be sent to our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. This address is for technical questions only. Comments and questions about the content of this meeting may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. There, you can click on the link that says County Commissioners to learn more about the commissioners, read minutes and agendas of commissioner meetings, and find other information about the county commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments.